Hello guys, Global Studio here today for your SOLIDWORKS tips and tricks. In this video we will learn how to make this C part with hexagonal edges, also with sharp corners. Guys, also please make sure to watch this video completely so that you will get the tricks I used in this video. Without delay, let's get started. Just click to the part and give OK, and then create a sketch in the front plane. Go to line, create one horizontal line, and also create one more horizontal line on the opposite side, and then give the dimension 200, and also opposite side we have to give 200 again. Then we have to create 3-point arc between the two edges like this, and then just give the dimension 350 radius. After that, just click OK and exit the sketch. Go to revolved boss or base, then click to the axis, then just give OK. After that, we have to create our hexagonal profile. Just go to right plane, create sketch, and take the normal view and create hexagon. Take the hexagon option and select the midpoint, then just click to the edge. Make this line horizontal and make sure the corner points are touching to the orange colored circular profile. Then create one box like this. After that, you have to make these extra lines for construction. Make this line also for construction, then just exit the sketch. Now we have to create the path. Just take the front plane and create the sketch. We already created one sketch for the revolve boss base. Just click to the sketch and click to the connote entities. Create one line because we need to trim the extra lines. Just trim the extra lines here and here and here. Delete this line also, and after that exit the sketch and take the swept boss swept cut option, then select the profile, and after that just leave OK. Then click to the swept cut feature, go to circular pattern and select the circular profile of this. Take the front view of this. As you can see guys, here we need total 6 corners like this, then give OK. We created hexagonal profile or shape for one side. Now click to that two features and mirror it to the next side. Click to the right plane and give OK. Now we have to take the flex option, type the flex in the command, and make sure it is clicked to the twisting option. Then select the part and give the angle 180 degree. And after this, as you can see guys here, the change, and make sure these two values are 0, and then just click OK. Now again we have to go to the flex option, type flex here and go to flex. Make sure this is checked in the bending. Now select the part and give the angle 270 degree. As you can see guys here, our C part is created now, but its diameter is very big. That we can change later. We created sharp corners also in the both ends, and also hexagon shape. Now we can change its diameter by changing the revolve option. Edit this revolve option radius to 750 and give OK. Now we can see the changes. Somewhat it is okay, right? Yes. And after this, we have to give the appearances. Just go to appearance. For rendering purpose, I am using KeyShot. So for that, you have to give different color for different edges. I'm giving different colors for different edge here. Now we will follow only two colors, that is black or white, or red or white, red or black, something like that. For three faces, you have to give red color. Rest of that you can leave as it is. Then I have one export option here for KeyShot. I am exporting using this tool. Now I exported my model. As you can see guys here, I just opened the model in KeyShot, but we will change that color to red and white. We will try different color. We will try black. Again, add the red on the other side. We have to give alternate colors. We have to give red, black here, again red over there, and one side we have to give black again, this side. As you can see guys here, our part is created now. It looks beautiful, right? Yeah, that's all for this video guys. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you got this video properly. If you got this video properly, then please don't forget to like and subscribe, as it is very important for me to grow my channel and bring lot of interesting videos to you guys. Thank you for watching this video. I will meet you in the next video. Bye bye.